The devil sets up distractions to distract you from the truth, so you cannot hear God or to not spend time in his word. Many celebrities and musicians are actually propped up by the devil, put in place by the devil. And this is no conspiracy theory, Illuminati talk, this is real talk. A lot of people, a lot of those celebrities are working for the devil and they don't even know it. Most of them don't know it. They are working for the devil, pushing sin, pushing homosexuality, pushing violence, and pushing his agenda. If the devil can get you to live a life of sin, then he's got you. Because his whole point is him trying to get you to go where he's going. Thank you for clicking on today. Today we are going to talk about the devil in the music industry. And he's all over. He's not even hiding anymore. Maybe he's never been hiding in my whole lifetime. Maybe it's been very apparent. And thinking about the generations and generations, he's definitely kicking it up a notch. I'd say since 2015, things have been real bad. Like, you could just see it. You could see it. You could feel it. There was such an increase of sinful music in 2015 to 16. There was before that, of course, obviously, for hundreds of years, thousands of years, it's been the whole time. But it's just, he's going hard, and I feel it again. I see so many Christians not paying attention, not knowing what's happening for real. And I was just like that. I mean, I knew a lot of it was bad, but still, when I was far from God, it didn't feel off. It felt fine because this is what I grew up with. This is what it is. This is the music. This is the music industry. But, as I got closer to God, I was like, oh, snap. What's going on? And so this video is really for that. This video is for non-believers and believers to show y'all that, hey, he's everywhere. He's everywhere and you're bumping it. And please stop. Seriously. Okay, so I'm going to start off by reading a little bit from Lil Nas X. Why am I putting myself through this? I'm going to read a little bit from his song, J. Christ. He's recently in his Christian era. I think that's a Taylor Swift sort of reference. I'm going to read some stuff in the song, okay?
Okay, so these are the lyrics, part of the lyrics for the song, J. Christ. I'm going to start right here. Back up out the gravesite. B word, I'm back like J. Christ. I'm finna get the gaze hype. I'm finna take it yay high. Back up out the gravesite. B, I'm back like J. Christ. I'm finna take it, I'm finna take it yay high. And then there's more parts. He's just talking about going viral. And when I come back, it's all for take. I'm in my prize. B word once again. I'm back like J. Christ. I'm taking it high. Blah, blah, blah. I'd say the lyrics are pretty bad just for cursing and for using Jesus in this way. The worst part of this is terrible is the lyrics, but also what's terrible is really these freaking visuals, what he's doing, what he's portraying in the music video. That's really the worst part of this entire song, J. Christ. But also, of course, the cursing is very bad.
Yeah, Fubo, please, get out of here, man.
You see, it's terrible. It's absolutely terrible. Even the stuff he's done stuff before with the Call Me By My Name video, where he's like twerking on a devil and he's on a pole and he slides down on a devil and then he did a bunch of crazy things in that video and sold a shoe with human blood. That was controversial. So he's done these things. He says that people are judging him off of the video I just made. Call Me By My Name. He's saying people are judging him for that and that this video is not meant to be a mockery, that people are taking it the wrong way. Bro, how? Like, bro, look, y'all just heard what I read, right? Y'all saw the clips. I think he's really bugging out. And it's like, he's saying he's really, you can't really be a Christian and be homosexual. You cannot. You can't live that way. You can't really be a Christian and live as a homosexual. Just the same way that you can't be a Christian and live a life of no repentance, of living a life of sin with no repentance in a different way, you know? Because I don't want to just pick on homosexuality. It's any of these sins. It's any repentive sin that you have not repented for. It's all that. It could be a straight man having sex outside of marriage repeatedly, constantly. That man is just as bad. You know, and a lot of people are going to learn. A lot of Christians are going to learn. Let's pull this out. Let's pull up Hebrews 10:26. If we decide to continue sinning after we have learned the truth, then there's no other sacrifices that will that will take away sins. If we continue sinning, all that is left for us is a fearful time of waiting for the judgment and the angry fire that will destroy those who live against God. I'll keep going. No, you're not sold. You're not buying it. Okay. Whoever refused to obey the law of Moses and was found guilty from testimony given by two or three witnesses, such people were not forgiven. They were killed. So think of how much more punishment people deserve who show their hate for the Son of God. People who show they have no respect for the blood sacrifice that began the new agreement and once made them holy. It's gonna be a scary day and scary times for Christians. We have to repent. We've been told this, honestly, somewhat of a lie by all these churches and pastors, and maybe you trusted them, that, oh, we have grace. You can do what you want. You're fine. You know, just keep living. And we do have grace, but that's if we sin, not when we sin. So if you're stuck in repetitive sin and you're just thinking, oh, I'm good, I'm straight, sir, ma'am, you are not. You will not repent from that. We are called to be holy. We are called to be perfect, just like our Father is perfect. That's what we're called to. Not to all lollygag and be sin and be children of the devil and I believe in Jesus, so I'm going to heaven too. The demons believe in Jesus too. That's all I'm going to say. I'll hit you with another one. 1 John 5:18. We know that those who have been made God's children do not continue to sin. The Son of God keeps them safe. The evil one cannot hurt them. You do not continue to sin. If you're a child of God, you do not continue to sin. Another one, John 5:29. Then they will come out of their graves. Those who did good in this life will rise and have eternal life. But those who did evil, which is sin, evil will rise to be judged guilty. Bible. Okay, this next one. This next one's tough. This next one, I love this guy. I grew up listening to this guy. This is Justin Timberlake. Man, JT. Bro, like I said, I've been listening to Bro since I was six. I was sad. Seeing this performance in this song kind of made me start this video. This is what made me go, okay, enough. This is a catalyst. I'm using this to make the video. But I'm never going to listen to him again unless he repents. Because this song is just trash. And it's honestly terrible. Like, Justin, what the heck are you doing? Like, I'm about to read you something from it now.
Something about how we break all the rules, make a sinner feel so blessed. You take all my wrongs, move right along, take me and fix my mess. Get me when I'm low, hand on my soul, like you see right inside. I come out a new man, no blood on my hands, blah, blah, blah. Sanctified, rid me of my sins, then you forgive them. Make me a new man, and I'm sanctified. Rid me of my sins, take me and forgive them. Okay, can I get a witness, sanctified? When I want to repent, surrender my all. Right hand on your right at your throne, and I do it again. Yeah, you crucify me, burn me up until there's nothing left inside me. My religion, my love, baptized in your ocean, willing and open, never enough. Yeah, you never judge me. You just take your halo, put it right above me. He says more crap like that, but then let's go to this next section. He's still talking to the women in the song. I get down on my knees, and every night I pray for you. Don't you see you're my savior? I'm made for you. I get down on my knees every night, and I pray for you. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Don't you see you're my savior? Yeah, talking right to the women. Don't love that, JT.
Brother, this guy stinks!
I mean, where do I even start? The whole thing is just terrible and bad. Make her sinner feel blessed. You know, rid me of my sins, then you forgive them, make a new man, I'm sanctified. You know, saying he's baptized in her ocean. It's something about breaking all the rules, make a sinner feel blessed. Yeah, you know, it's pretty bad. It's pretty bad stuff. I can't stand it. The biggest reason why I wanted to even, like, say this song in a video is because, like, this is something that the devil is doing. I'm sure it's not new, but he is giving it a Christian twist. Which is honestly very disrespectful. Like, he's doing it with Lil Nas X with the Jesus thing. He's doing it with Justin now. Oh, Justin. To quote all these, to twist these scriptures and use it for a sex song. And then he even does it with Beyonce, you know, someone who, and many artists who say, I'm a Christian, but yet put out completely non-Christian material. And that's who we're talking about next.
So this is from the Beyonce Lemonade album that she did with HBO. She's saying she fasted without sex and fasted in that time. My hair grew past my ankles. I slept on a mat. I swallowed a sword. I levitated. Went to the basement, confessed my sins, and I was baptized in a river, got on my knees and said amen, and said, I mean, I whipped my own back and asked for dominion at your feet. Whose feet? I threw myself into a volcano. I drank the blood and drank the wine. I sat alone and begged and bent my waist for God. I crossed myself and thought I saw the devil. I grew thickened skin on my feet. I bathed in bleach and plugged my menses with pages from the holy book. Come on now, this girl.
I said, hold up, wait a minute, something ain't right.
Absolutely twisted and just weird. No one talks about this anymore.
Yeah, I wouldn't call that holy. Yeah, no, actually, I'd say the very opposite. I think saying that you'd use the Bible as a tampon is pretty bad. It's pretty wicked. I'd say that came from the devil. I don't know. Maybe she cooked it up herself. Either way, the devil loved it. Like, you know, some people still say, oh, but she's Christian, yo, she's good, she's Christian. Let me list some stuff from her new album, or it was new, from 2022. This is from the song. This is how it starts. It says, please, mother, ain't stopping me. Please, mother. It does that about 8 times. Actually, a lot longer. Then she says, cause I'm on that ho. Can I say ho? Dead A. I'm dead A. N-word self. What you got to make me rich? Never get the P. The kitty cat. Cause it's off limits. Garden tool once again. running the game when you claiming that other B. I'm that girl. Very humble. That's just track one. Don't need drugs for some freak-ish. I'm just high all the time. I'm out of my mind. I'm tweaking. Yes, you are, Beyonce. I'm glad you know it. I'm glad you admitted it. Thank you. That's just track one. I could go through the entire album. I'd rather not, but this video is long enough. And you know what's really sad is a lot of Beyonce fans defend her or like her, but oh, she's Christian like me. And yes, she's Christian like you in the way that she doesn't really live a Christian lifestyle. Yeah. Turn from that music, turn from that lifestyle, repent, truly keep the commandments, and God will feel that love. Real talk. So yeah, very unholy things. I think we should all repent and live a different lifestyle. We all have enjoyed this type of music, but it's raps. I do believe Beyonce is a Christian. I do believe it. I think she is a Christian. But when you look at her album covers recently, what her outfits that she wore on tour, you look at the movie poster for the tour, you know, because she turned the tour into a movie. It's none of it says Christian. None of it's holy. In fact, all of it's unholy, just like this guy we're about to talk about. I'm going to read a little bit from Sam Smith's hit song that many people my age and younger listen to, unfortunately. The song was called Unholy.
Okay, mommy don't know, daddy's getting hot at the body shop, doing something unholy. He sat back while she's dropping it, she be popping it. Yeah, she put it down slowly. And then that's really the worst part of the song. It's actually pretty clean when it comes to cursing. There's no real cursing. It's basically just a sex song about adultery and about fornication, which is in so many songs. I could have used literally, I'm gonna say thousands, but I literally could have used probably hundreds of thousands or millions of songs that show nowadays, or just over the past 20 years of fornication. But I'm choosing this song because of really just this performance. Look how demonic it is. It's right up in our face. It's called Unholy. I think there's a backward, upside down cross in the artwork for the song, but it's just clearly worship for the devil during these performances.
Okay, yeah, and guess what? It lived up to the name as well as the performance. Very devilish, very evil. Song is very evil. I never heard the song until now. I just saw the title and was always like, yeah, no. And if it came on the radio, if I was ever in the car, but yeah, no. Next channel. Like, I didn't give it a second. I was like, oh, Unholy? I know what type of time you're on. I know what type of life you live. Okay, I'm off. But look, the devil is not hiding anything. It's right in our face. It kind of always has been. It's right in our face. We need to turn away from this stuff. I've been turned away from it. I'm talking about y'all. But I say we because, you know, we like that. We fam. We need to turn away from this stuff. The devil is putting it right in our face, and yet so many Christians listen to and love this music. And I used to love secular music too. I used to absolutely love secular music. I used to listen to secular music too until one day, glory to God, I was like, dang, I'm not really messing with all this gang talk. Like, all this gang and shooting talk. I don't really like this. Like, it's a lot. It's a lot now. I don't like it. So I was like, man, anything in the gang stuff, man, I don't care if it's not even a big part of the song. Like, I'm not, the whole song is dead to me. And then eventually one day I was like, hey, yo, all this having sex outside of marriage stuff is, I'm not with it, bro. I'm not with that. And then, like, all the, like, alcohol and drugs and all, I was like, because I've never even done these things. I don't even do these things. I'm just like, yo, I'm not with all this. What's going on? Like, I'm like, you know, it's like, if it's contrary to what my Lord, my God wants me to live, how he wants me to live. It's like, I was like, bro, why am I listening to this stuff? Like, this stuff is evil. Like, I'm reading all, you know, all these things. And it was once I was growing, you know, closer to God. I was like, I'm reading about all these sins and stuff. I'm like, this is everything. This is what that is. This is all that. And I knew that before, but it was still like, oh, it was just very clear. Like, yeah, this ain't it. Like, all this is disrespectful to my Father. Why am I listening to this? You know, and I stopped listening. I'd say I've mainly stopped listening to secular music. I don't really listen to any of it. Like, I'd say like 95% of my music is all godly, all worship, all gospel. Some of it is like secular, but it's clean. Like, shout out to Jacob Collier. I don't even know what else I'd listen to secularly. You could say the Donda album from Kanye is secular, but I would argue it's like somewhere in between. So it's like, it's weird. It's like, it's, but a lot of my music is clean. It is biblical. Shout out to Caleb Gordon. I don't know why I named him first, sure. Shout out to Forrest Frank. Shout out to Holvey. Shout out to Sunday. That's my guy. Shout out to maybe me a little bit. I got some songs. Click on, I got some songs. I know, right? What? Me? Yeah, I got a couple. Shout out to all these Christian artists. You can find it if you want it. And like, that's what I was going through. I was like, man, like, I'm trying to find some Christian songs that sound like the songs I like. And that's why I'm making songs right now. But it's like, there's all these artists who do amazing. You will find it. You can replace. If you're like, man, oh, but Beyonce just slaps. Oh, but DaBaby slaps. I don't know. What do y'all listen to nowadays? I don't even know. Oh, but, you know, Young Thug slap. You can listen. You can find it. You can find hip-hop, R&B, good music with good production outside of secular stuff. It can happen. Turn away from it. Repent from your sins. Repent from that music. And hey, thank y'all for watching. Glory to God. I'm so happy y'all watched. Let's go through this walk together. And just remember, Jesus is King. Love y'all. And this is for anyone saying that, oh, homosexuality was only, you know, God was only against it in the Old Testament. It was only a law in the Old Testament. Homosexuality is okay now. Let me read you something from the New Testament. 1 Corinthians 6, 9/10. Surely you know that people who do wrong will not get to enjoy God's kingdom. Don't be fooled. These are the people who will not get to enjoy his kingdom. Those who sin sexually, those who worship idols, those who commit adultery, men who let other men use them for sex or have sex with other men, those who steal, those who are greedy, those who drink too much, those who abuse others with insults, and those who cheat. Now for my lesbians, let me give you something too, lesbians. Let me, because I've seen some lesbians go, it's always men on men. Then God never says something about women on women. I don't know why they talk. This is for my lesbians, okay. Romans 1:26. For this reason, God gave them over to degrading and vile passions. For their women exchanged the natural function for that which is unnatural. And in the same way, the men turned away from natural function of women and were consumed with the desire for one another. So you see, lesbians, look, hey, women on women bad too.